gentlemen, welcome. So many familiar faces here at the fanfare concert, and we're so glad to see you back, some new faces. This is a special concert tonight. It's for the musical, the memory of the musical life of Mr. Joe Stein. I'm thinking back about these opening remarks, and I'll keep them very brief. I could go on and on and on, especially if I had a martini in one hand, and I could really go on and on. Joe would have one in his hand, and then we could both go on and on. But I was thinking back how far back I have known Joe as a musician, and of course, our principal trumpet player back here, Mr. John Baker, has known Joe way longer than that, played with him for years before I did, and I'm thinking back 20-some years. I played in his band. He was a fantastic pianist. I can tell you stories about him accompanying people who would just come up and say, I want to sing a tune. Well, okay, what key? They'd start to sing and he'd go, okay, there it is. And he'd say, okay, guys, and he'd yell the key and we'd accompany people. We did all of the balls and programs for the Gasparilla people. We did the fair. Just so many things that we did together. And then one day, Joe called me up and said, hey, I want to come and play in your band. I said, what? Joe, well, you know, we didn't play the piano. He said, no, I don't play piano. I got a French horn. And that was my first instrument when I first began to play. And I wanted to come play in your band. And I said, well, you know, no other musician than Joe is. I said, well, come on down. Come and sit in. Our first rehearsal's Tuesday for the next concert. Come and sit in and see how you do. Well, he loved it. He just loved it. And he would practice like crazy and talk about the music. And it became a whole different thing with Joe. So that when I was in his band and he was the boss, it was still fun. It was always fun with Joe. And when he worked hard, but it was always fun. And that's what he liked about this group too. He said, yeah, these people are serious and they want to play really fine music. And so, you know, I really love this. So we planned this concert as a tribute to Joe Stein. There are a lot of different kinds of music in this concert. Some of it he hadn't played, but he had such a wide interest in music that we tried to touch a lot. For instance, we have show music. He loved Broadway shows, and he could accompany. One time we were playing a big society ball, and there were two men who had actually played the Phantom of the Opera on Broadway. Unfortunately, they sang the tunes in two different keys. And Joe just smiled and changed keys and accompanied them. First thing he did is say, you guys go take a break. I'll take care of this. But that's the kind of musician Joe was. So we put some Broadway in here. We put Molly on the Shore because It was really a trying time for Joe. It has very demanding horn parts. You'll hear it. And Brad couldn't make that concert, and Joe decided he had to take up the slack, and he just practiced Molly on the Shore, so we put that in the concert. His March to Gino is coming later on, and I'll have a couple of comments to say about that. That is his original march, a real Italian march. I'm going to talk about that a little when it comes up. He loved to play in the bands, in the church bands, in the city bands, and he loved Italian overtures. And I love Italian overtures. And so we're going to end the whole concert with Italian and Algiers, the overture to that wonderful concert. So this, all of these pieces are a tribute to his wide interest in music. And we love Joe. We loved him when he was here. And I know already smiling right now, just waiting for me to make a mistake so he'd go. Never said anything bad, just listen. So let's do Strike Up the Day. have been our finale. We're going to follow it with another very beautiful piece. The program notes are in your program there. This is Molly on the Shore by Percy Granger, one of our favorite composers for a concert band. This is the piece that I talked about earlier. Has some all of these pieces have demanding horn parts, and then you can hear our wonderful horn section over here playing it. This piece right here is very demanding on the woodwind section. Oh, well, the whole band, really. And we hope you enjoy Molly on the Shore. I'd like to make one little announcement here. Debbie Felton does the programs for us. And Debbie does these beautiful programs for every concert, including the program notes. And she does it in memory of her husband, Lee Felton, who was a longtime tuba player with Fanfare Winds and the president of our organization. So can we have a nice round of applause?
Thank you. that in the back. That was before, you want to turn it?
No.
Birds, okay. He's had a great career at McLean Middle School. He set some standards that were off the charts for middle school programs. And since we've done, he went to Chamberlain High School and finished up at Gaithersburg. The first time I met you was when we were at Gaithersburg High School and I was at Hillsborough. Since that time, he's been a principal at Madison Middle School and Buren Middle School, and he serves now as a consultant, I guess, for substitute teachers and quite a few other things within the district. So, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Vincent Lewis.
In a frame of mind as you're walking through the channel side area around the forum, Harbor Island, you're hearing the ships coming in, you're hearing the trolley going by, you're looking at into the different shops and so forth. If you're a wife and you're taking a little bit more time and your husband is pulling and saying, come on, let's move this train a little bit and so forth. So I hope this number depicts that for you.
Thank you.
know something a little bit about the literature, and this is a very good chart. This is called American Folk Crafts Literature.
Thank you.
piece is an original march by Joe Stein. He wrote this and dedicated it to a friend of his who was in one of the community bands that we played in. And his name was Joe Ticino, and he's still playing clarinet well into his 90s. And Joe and I had a similar background when we were coming up, in that we both played in the Italian bands, the Italian church bands. I was in Denver, he was in Philadelphia. He played French horn and I played clarinet, but we had a similar experience in that all of the band directors were short little Italians that played clarinet and had this huge drumstick that when the band wasn't playing right, they would pounce on the stand or even throw it. And so Joe wrote this march and he said, "Will you play this march?" I said, "Sure, you know." He said, "Well, it's an Italian march, you know." I said, "Yeah." He said, "Of course you know that the most important instruments in the Italian march are the bass drum player and the cymbal player." Because when Italian bands spend a whole day going around the neighborhood and then they get to the churchyard and the, you know, the sausages are frying and the beer's flowing, sometimes we don't really get it. So we need a real strong bass drum. And when we were rehearsing it this first time, Joe used to turn around. Brad reminded me, Bradley, our French horn player, reminded me that he used to turn around and go, come on, play. So this is in the spirit of a real Italian march. So just imagine yourself in a little square in Umbria or Amalfi or wherever, and this is the Italian band at about 10 o'clock at night in the churchyard.
Thank you.
platoon man, as I just alluded to. He, his band played every type of genre you can possibly imagine, and a lot of Broadway. But he really thought it was appropriate. We had to do one tune that we could jam as many tunes in 8 minutes as humanly possible. And we found that piece. A Broadway journey.
I
discussed. They're going to set up some cookies. Hyatt over here gave me cue cards at the beginning, and I forgot to announce them. I was so excited about talking about Joe. So please turn off your cell phones.
Thank you.
contract.